Yo, what? It's already the finals already? That's crazy. Anyway, you know what's up. There's one match in winner's bracket this week, and then there's just going to be a slaughter in loser's bracket. The pool's the same size as last week, so I don't really have anything else to say, except let's just get into the maps.
Except this pool was finalized Tuesday, so I only had 3 days to edit this before I went on vacation for the weekend, and
what else do you expect from Nomad 1 at this point? Seekin is pretty much from Sylphia in a way you would expect from a Nomad 1 map. You get some large aim patterns, which are consistent throughout the entire map, and a fair amount of 200 BPM boys that make this not an aim hand only map. Also, don't get Walforded at the end.
It's a world pan map, but not customized for this tournament. This Nomad 2 is nothing out there, just being streams and jumps. There are quite a few jump patterns and some kickslider jumps at the end. That means you actually have to work on your aim for this stream map if you hope to full combo, but otherwise, it's just long streams at fair spacing, so just your everyday stream map.
The finals Nomad 3 is definitely one that will grind some players' gears. Packed with heavy slider aim control, and a little bit of pattern recognition, this modern slider map will make anyone that tries to accurately play this go crazy, and Scorby 2 does not make that easier.
Humanoid. Alt. Yes. Don't get too comfortable though. The impurity difficulty of this set from X-Lollicore has a mix of both flow and snap alt patterns, and you'll need to contend with a lot of cut quads scattered throughout both the verse and ki sections of this map. There's also a fair amount of 1/6 burst that you need to hit as well if you don't want to lose your combo between ki's.
OWC map, Toho, 235 beats per minute, long burst, consecutive burst, spaced burst, 1/3 maybe, big circle, no break, haha, finger, go brrrr.
It's Nomad 6 time, and we have a very familiar one this time around. Sputnik 4, mapped by Consumer of Bean, who is also the voiceover and the replay. This map is pretty interesting in the fact that it has, like, zero aim, period. However, when it comes to the finger control, this map is very difficult in that regard, hence why the 5-star rating is a little bit inaccurate. There's also a little bit of a reading component and a little bit of pattern recognition, and at OD9 you are going to struggle to act this.
Linear aim is the name of the game in our first hidden pick. Chicago is not only a cool place, but also a map by 210 BPM offering not only the linear aim, but also different spacing, weird stream shapes, and slowdowns with quickly followed speedups as well.
If you were in pain with the previous Hidden 2s being A maps, prepare for even more pain as Yokespie's difficulty on Hanakagero not only features aim, but also 1/6 quads, spaced bursts, and, in order to justify putting the map in the slot, a lot of overlaps and stacks of differing rhythms, topped off with CS5 just like last week, as well as the usual A rate. You guys will be fine though, a 5-digit managed to Lewis R. Vaxey on this map.
To Nomad 6, we've got more finger control for Hidden 3. However, the last world of music differs greatly from Sputnik in that these patterns are actually hard to aim as well. Cut flow aim with dispersed 1/4 bursts appear all over the place as you can so clearly see from the replay. If you're crazy enough to single tap this, then your jackhammer fingers are gonna need to be as equally as ready as your aim control.
More aim! Polka Stiff on Hanabi features a lot of comfortable jumps in this map, but you should be wary about the bursts in this one, especially since this is on Hard Drug. For an aim Hard Drug map, this is quite fast at 232 BPM, but at least you don't have to worry much about hitting ridiculously spaced streams. Your focus should be on hitting these fast jumps and making sure you don't lose too much accuracy on this long burst. Also, this is just too fast for Hard Drug, man.
Hard Rock 2. Yes, finger control. We nerfed it, lol. Good luck.
Psyque. Must I say more? Filling in the last Hard Rock slot, we got a Psyque tech. This definitely will push your aim control on the mod to its limits with space bursts, hard kick sliders, and quite a few changes in the overall pace of the map. I can already feel all the slider breaks on this map, and they hurt.
Heading into the DT pool, we start off with the collab insane diff of Inuitoko's Kimagure Romantic. This map features relatively comfortable, almost farmy jumps, but with very high spacing, especially in the Hiyais, with only one break time to rest your aim hand. This map is no joke on the tapping either, with 255 BPM bursts going as high as 7 notes, as well as bursts that go immediately into single taps or another burst. Good pool, has VTubers, I approve!
While this set has some spicy maps like Jonzon's Extra and Labyrinth of Steam, we decided to be nice and make you play one of the more standard maps. This is still no joke though. This is the fastest map in any of the Cope Cup pools so far, being 278 BPM, and it has the speed patterns to back up that scary large number. While the stamina requirement of pools past isn't really there, there are very few people that can play this BPM comfortably. If you have one of those type of players on your team, there might be a chance for you to snag a 1v3 or 1v4 opportunity on this map.
This map basks in the glory of its double sections around the halfway point, surrounded on both sides by long stream sections. If you're lucky enough to hit them in match, you still have to deal with the nerve fallout afterwards, as the sections that follow are a product of their time, having been made in 2012. They'll surely hit a lot harder than expected.
For our last double time slot, we have the Clockwork Rose. Even though this is only 203 BPM after double time, don't let that fool you. This map is cluttered with awkward stream patterns that stop and start on a dime. This is definitely the most finger control that we've gotten so far in this tournament. Make sure that you have a stellar left hand, as we're going into the finals and grand finals soon. You're gonna need all the help you can on these crazy DT4 maps.
We're kicking off the free mod pool this week with yet another CS4 AR9 map, but we're going to be taking a departure from the classic awkward aim you're accustomed to seeing in this slot. CRN's map of Cosmic Drive checks to see if you're capable of aiming some older style alt patterns regardless of which mod you take. No AR10 cheesing for you non-Hard Rock players either. You'll need to have really good reading on this because it is a dense map at 256 BPM.
This is a super common free mod map in open rank tournaments, and looking at the quality of the map, you can see why. This map tests your consistency at either mod pool in a very drastic way. Rather it be flow aim hidden streams at a low approach rate, or the combination of awkward jumps and precision on hard rock. This is even easyable for some of you people out there. Any Badooers in chat?
Toho and Eurobeat? The famous love set of Justice Monster makes its appearance in the free mod pool with its CS2 difficulty. Unhidden, your flowing and reading will be pushed to its limits with its alt-esque flow. Hard Rock, despite it being a CS2 base, will push your flowing and finger control even further with its space 160 BPM flow patterns. It might play hard, but hey, it bangs even harder. Here we go, another Idki tiebreaker. Abyss is another variety tiebreaker testing all your skills once more. Your tapping hand will not be put under as much strain compared to previous weeks, with much less string patterning. But your right hand will be tested more than ever with jump patterns at awkward angles spaced at quite a bit. It isn't even just one jump pattern here and there. Pattern after pattern will come at you testing your consistency and nerves with every circle. It also sits at 215 BPM. So have fun trying to keep pace with the song.